the fourth part of the duodenum. So fourth part of the duodenum and the jejunum is the main point where the root of the mesentery arises, because this point along the vertebrae, it presents along the lumbar second vertebra. So it originated from the lumbar second vertebra just in between the duodeno-jejunal junction, or where the duodenum ends and the jejunum begins. From that place, the lumbar second vertebra, the root of the mesentery arises, and which will ends in the sacroiliac joints. So here the sacroiliac joints. So what are the structures that cross the root of the mesentery? Where you can see the third part of the duodenum and the abdominal aorta, inferior vena cava, and also the gonadal vessels. So this is the right-sided gonadal vessels. In case of male, it is testicular artery, and in case of female, it is ovarian vessels. So testicular vessels, that both artery and vein, and ovarian vessels, both artery and vein. And also you can see a tubular structures. It is called the ureter. So right-sided ureter also crossed by the root of the mesentery. And there is a group of muscle fiber you can see. This is called the psoas major and also the genitofemoral nerve. So right-sided genitofemoral nerve. So it is, this question is invariably asked in the exam, that what are the structures that crosses the root of the mesentery. The second part is the free border of the mesentery. So centrally the root of the mesentery present, and the rest of the portion where the jejunum and ileum is suspended, this all portion is called the free border of the mesentery. So it is average 15 cm or maximum 6 inch long, and in sometimes maximum that is 20 cm or 8 inch. It can enlarge up to 8 inch. Moreover, average it's like 6 inch or 15 cm. Or if the gut, that is jejunum and ileum, is distended, the mesentery is also distended. It can be expanded up to 20 cm. That means the maximum breadth can go up to 20 cm. So the portion, that means a part of the free border of the mesentery, goes into the pelvis to enclose the pelvic viscera. So sometimes the paralytic ileus or loss of peristaltic movement occurs due to the inflammation of the pelvic part of the mesentery. So pelvic peritoneum or the pelvic mesentery is sometimes infected. That's why paralytic ileus. Superior mesenteric artery and superior mesenteric vein. Also, there is a presence of
lymphatics, that is lacteals. Because in case of